How's it going, everybody? Welcome to a brand new video. Today we have a very exciting day in the world of cryptocurrency, as it's pretty much been a pretty exciting week. We've been seeing a pretty interesting return to a familiar time of cryptocurrency, which essentially the end of 2017. We were seeing a lot of these different technologies at their all-time highs. Bitcoin most notably back in the end of 2017, you will all remember fondly when it was at $20,000 for a single Bitcoin, and currently we're seeing it at $6,500. But definitely interesting to see the movement that's been happening with XRP lately. Of course, Bitcoin Cash also performing pretty magnificently. Quick hats off to everybody who saw Eternal Token and that coming. I mean, this has been a pretty wild ride as far as that. But I've been looking at it, and there's a significant trend that's been going on. We've been seeing Electronium getting some significant attention, XRP getting that same notoriety, of course, and really Cardano, which we've talked about multiple times on this channel before, then EOS, of course, too. So really the trend that I'd identify would have something to do with smart contracts, and definitely have something to do with the movements that are being made by the establishment on a much broader scale. It's really starting to interest me how we're seeing the establishment catching on and essentially taking up their own stake in the cryptocurrency department. And ultimately, we have a very interesting video today. It's going to be really discussing the particulars about the number 13 ranking cryptocurrency Tron, the Justin Sun vision, and essentially the Tron community at large, and what essentially cryptocurrency and this decentralized perspective of the internet applied to this sort of new vision of providing media using the decentralized network. It's a very, very ambitious, bold, but also necessary thing that realistically, when you look at how these platforms function, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, centralized leadership breeds a whole myriad of problems, which ultimately plague the user base as far as how we see these manipulated algorithms across there. I'm not going to name any particular social networks that are guilty of this individually, because I'm sure that you know which ones I'm talking about, which ones are more guilty of these things than others. I mean, social media sins, there's a list that goes a mile long of all these different accounts that have received different basically shadow bans and all these different things, a lot of different problems that are ultimately culminating in a steady decline. In particular, I would aim that sort of criticism at Twitter, because they definitely do have a reputation for basically depersoning people right off their platform, which really doesn't is no way to run a social media platform. The fundamental point should be providing the media to the people who are looking at it, regardless of what that media is, as long as it follows those specific guidelines. The minute these different social media platforms began to betray their own guidelines, that's when their user base loses trust in them to a significant degree, because people want to be able to play by the rules on these different social media platforms and share different ideas and not be fucked with. And essentially, that's fundamentally when we see Facebook and Twitter and all these different ones declining in stock value across the board. It's subsequently due to a large myriad of things, as we were speaking of earlier, regarding the way Facebook treats data, the way that they view their customers, the way that they treat their customers, and of course, the old standbys of that. Really, it's interesting because I'm not here to point fingers. I'm just here to point out this fundamental opening up of a really big, significant opportunity that very much it seems as if Tron's aware of it to a large extent. I mean, Justin Sun's already strategically placed Tron in a really, really big way. We're seeing Tron making some interesting headway into Japan, which is really going to be very interesting as we see this overall cryptocurrency. I mean, the fact that crypto is now at $216 billion, we've made it past the 190. Essentially, there was a lot of resistance at that 190, flipping over to the $216 now. And essentially, this is opening up a huge, huge opportunity as far as the continued developments in terms of the relationship that cryptocurrency has has with the public consciousness, the overall conversation that's taking place across the board as we see these different basically technologies positioning themselves, trying to get a piece of the pie. Because essentially when this whole charade that's happening right now of, you know, the Facebook, Twitter, all these different social media platforms, Instagram have a sort of monopoly on the attention and, you know, the usage of the youth culture and so forth. But all that's subject to change. Even the large, I mean, you have to remember back when Yahoo was the Google of the internet. And then, you know, at some point, Google will lose power in much the same way that all these other ones do. And ultimately, it's going to be an adapt or die situation, simply based on the fact that cryptocurrency offers a huge, huge, myriad of opportunities that is going to ultimately change the way that people use the internet in a hopefully in a positive direction if things are strategically pointed in that way. But you know, all these different conversations that we're seeing across the board regarding essentially censoring different perspectives, different points of view, different opinions, that are, you're really, this is a red flag in a lot of these different communities that have built themselves up on Twitter, because there's all these different communities that want to be able to use these platforms and feel safe and not have to worry about having all these different things. But this is also key why it's important to have a presence across multiple different platforms. So of course, if you guys are interested, make sure that you guys are following us on our official Twitter. We have this Twitter right here, which is at CryptoTuber. And another thing that I wanted to go into detail about is the importance of creating memes, the importance of creating your own memes and creating your own content. I mean, one of the things that I think is we're doing, that's one of the most ambitious things that this channel is actually partaking in, is now not only will we be focusing our attention on cryptocurrency and essentially, you know, all the various different things that we're already known for, but now we're expanding outwards. We're trying to focus on more broad media appeal, and that's going to include promoting SoundCloud rappers, basically similar to this guy Little Link. So definitely stay tuned for that, because we're going to be taking over the SoundCloud scene the same way that because we have been seeing already as far as that cultural thing goes. We were seeing rappers that have been talking about Bitcoin now and rapping about Bitcoin in their songs. And of course, this is very interesting stuff that's happening. I mean, this artist named Stephen Cannon, definitely with a dollar sign for Stephen. So, I mean, is that some sort of nod towards cryptocurrency? He does have a song called Bitcoin. So if you guys wanted to check that out, it's definitely worth your time, or at least giving a support to, even if you're not necessarily a fan of hip-hop music, it definitely does have a huge leverage over the youth culture. And when we see all these cool musicians and celebrities paying attention to cryptocurrency, it's very much the start of the cultural paradigm shift that's happening across the board, which is essentially a movement from seeing rappers that are really flexing with all this cash and fiat currency and, you know, United States denominations of $100 bills and so forth, and really moving into the digital era. And I think that this is definitely something that Tron has on their radar as well. It's essentially a cultural shift that's happening, and we already have been seeing Hollywood has been using cryptocurrency as a plot device. And essentially, I mean, it is interesting to see Ripple in particular. We mentioned that earlier in this video, but the fact that Ripple's been XRP's been performing so crazy lately. I mean, it's nothing compared to where it was in the past, but I mean, essentially within the one in the month time frame, people probably feeling pretty good about themselves who've been getting involved with XRP lately. So but then again, I mean, it's just a sort of a renewed confidence. But ultimately, I think that Tron definitely does represent the decentralized free internet, the original vision of what the internet is like global interconnected communication between people and sharing media content, basically free from the centralized control. And now that technology is really more possible now than ever, and it's really interesting to see Tron really standing up and taking a piece of the pie. So it's essentially going to be very interesting to see these things happening in real time. And I definitely encourage everybody to make their own media content, whatever your specific interest is, if you like music, all these different things, because it is a very interesting time. The means of distribution of information are becoming very decentralized. And now we're moving into the period where more and more people have smartphones, more people have access to information. So there's more people who are looking for more media. And there's essentially a vacuum that's opening up. So it's going to be interesting to see how these things culminate. And it also shout out to Adam22, because I'm pretty sure No Jumper was behind this Bitcoin song that came out. But it's definitely interesting to see the cultural shift that's been happening. I think Justin Sun certainly is a genius. And when you look at the track record of where Tron is planning on going and where they have gone so far, definitely interesting to see how things are going to be headed in the year 2019, 2020. It's very exciting stuff. But also make sure you remember, I'm not a financial advisor. This video is not advice by any means. This video is for creative, educational, inspirational purposes only. So remember, I'm not your dad. I'm basically just talking about my personal perspectives. And I would say that it's going to be interesting to see how Tron decentralizes the internet and brings this power into the hands of just the everyday people who have, essentially, you think about it, you have a computer, you have a smartphone, you have a certain degree of computing power, which is a leverageable amount of power that can be used in all sorts of directions. So it's a very interesting time now with the development of computers and the development of the power that's in the hands of just the everyday people. So all that being said, make sure that you guys are following us on Snapchat, or if you guys are interested, you could also follow us on our Twitter. Like I said, that's at CryptoTuber, and link will probably be in the description. I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a good one.